March 1979. 365 million miles from Earth. NASA's Voyager spacecraft hurtles toward a massive, mysterious world.
Jupiter is the largest planet in our solar system. But it's not a planet like Earth that you can walk on. It's a gas giant.
That gas is constantly in motion. It's a very turbulent atmosphere.
Voyager deploys its infrared sensors to collect temperature data from the swirling mass of Jupiter's clouds.
We expect to see temperatures around 200 Kelvin, which is minus 100 degrees Fahrenheit. It's pretty cold.
But Voyager's data reveals a shocking anomaly.
The upper atmosphere of Jupiter is much hotter than it should be.
In fact, what we find is it's 1300 degrees Fahrenheit.
That's ridiculously hot and hard to explain.
What strange power source could be at play on Jupiter?
One theory NASA scientists consider is the heat could be coming from Jupiter's explosive core.
It doesn't just burn. It explodes like continuous atomic bombs. And it radiates energy out.
Could the heat in Jupiter's core be powering these really hot temperatures in its atmosphere?
Because Jupiter's core is hotter than the surface of the sun.
NASA scientists conduct an astonishing experiment to investigate. In December 1995, the Galileo probe plummets to its doom through the layers of Jupiter's atmosphere. Before it implodes, the spacecraft sends back vital data, but the findings only deepen the mystery.
The lower atmosphere is much cooler. It's not hot. There's no obvious signature of heating, so it's not just like a big upwelling of heat from below.
Wherever the mysterious heat is coming from, it's not the planet's core.
How do you get warm stuff to jump over a cold area and then heat up an area above? There's really no way to really do that.
There is another way Jupiter's atmosphere could be generating heat. Charged particles from the sun constantly strike Jupiter's magnetic field, releasing energy in dazzling displays called aurorae.
These auroras produce 1 million watts of power. That's 1,000 times more powerful than the Earth's auroras. So could the intense heat produced by the auroras at the poles of Jupiter be responsible for the high temperatures we see in the atmosphere?
The theory seems to fit until scientists examine Hubble images of Jupiter's atmosphere. The infrared pictures show the heat from Jupiter's aurorae gets no further than the planet's poles. Something is holding the heat in place.
The problem with Jupiter is that it has a really fast spin. In that, heat can't propagate down, which effectively means it just gets captured at the poles.
We can explain why the poles of Jupiter are hot, but it turns out all of Jupiter is hot.
So we have a big conundrum.
It's very frustrating.
Every time we think we've come up with an answer, it disappears again.
In December 2016, scientists working with Hawaii's Mauna Kea Observatory released new findings that could offer a clue to the mystery. Their temperature data comes from the gas giant's notorious red spot.
Now, Jupiter's red spot is an extremely intense, very large star, as big as the diameter of the Earth.
Could Jupiter's giant red spots be blasting the atmosphere with heat?
Astronomer Tom Stollard is on the research team.
We saw a spike in the radiation of light from the upper atmosphere.
Using our spectral analysis, we were able to show that that was brighter because it was much hotter, and incredibly hot. It's hundreds of degrees hotter than the rest of the planet.
Scientists propose the storms within the red spot could be sending out sound waves, which transport energy through the clouds. When the waves hit the thin upper atmosphere, they release their energy as heat. Scientists have recorded similar acoustic waves releasing some heat into the clouds over the Andes in South America. Whether this acoustic wave effect could generate enough heat to be responsible for the massive Jupiter anomaly is unknown.
We have several pretty nice theories, but all of them have problems.
Scientists need more data before we can really figure out what's going on, Jupiter.